All right, here's the cutting and squaring stock practice activity. This is one of the most difficult things you'll do in woods, and that is trying to figure out how to take a piece of wood like this and break it down into the individual parts you need for a project. Okay, to do this, we need to know the six steps of cutting and squaring stock in order, and I'm going to show you this with the tools. Looking at my worksheet here, we're going to start by using a jointer to joint the face of the wood. Use the jointer to joint the edge of the wood, and then we're going to switch to the table saw to joint it, or to table saw it to width, a planer to plane it to thickness, and we'll use the miter saw to cut each end. Okay, and even though I already have one end that looks square, I'm going to go ahead and cut one end off here and then measure to length to cut my second end. Okay, as I'm doing this, I'll explain which steps can be reversed. A couple of these we can do in different orders. Okay, we need to start with a board that's a little longer than 12 inches long. Because I know I'm going to make some adjustments to this. So I'll use my tape measure. And for this video, I'm going to make my markings in pen just so you can see them, but you would do this with pencil. Okay, I know that my tape measure is going to slide a little bit right here, but this is a rough measurement, so it doesn't matter. So I'm going to measure 12 and a half, maybe a little more than 12 and a half inches. Doesn't matter super much. This is just a rough cut. After this, we'll start getting more precise. Okay, so let's break this down. We're going to square this to size first, and then we're going to start making our individual pieces. Okay, I'm here at the jointer. The first step in cutting and squaring stock is to joint one face. Okay, I've got this board that's free of knots. I have this one surface here I want to try to avoid. I'm going to start here. This board's pretty flat, so it looks like maybe one pass will do it. I'm going to use a push stick on the back of the board to push it through. And this board's short enough, I don't need anything on the front. If it were any longer, I'd use a push block to hold down the front. I'm going to make a single pass through and check it. Okay, examining the other side, looks like it made a cut all the way through. So now we're on to step two. Step two is to take the face I just jointed, put it up against the fence. I'm going to use a push stick to push it, and I'm going to use a push block just to hold it tight against the fence. I don't want it to rock away from the fence. Okay, that's step two. I now have two edges squared. Third step now will be to go to the table saw and trim off this edge. I'm just going to do a little bit to true it up, but I know I'm going to make this into smaller pieces, so it doesn't matter what thickness I do. If I were making a single block, I would make my next cut to the final size. I don't know if you can see this, but there is a bit of a curve to this right here. Okay, we're going to take that off with a planer in just a minute. On to step three. Okay, I'm at the table saw. I need to set the height of the blade for my wood. And I want it a quarter of an inch above the wood there. And as I look at this, I can see that this is out of square right here, and I've got this round part here. This board definitely needs to be squared. Okay, double check my angle that we're at 0 degrees and the saw is on. And I'm gonna set my fence. On this one, I'm just guessing a little bit. I know I'm gonna need at least 3 1/4 inches. So we'll set 3 1/4 inches. It might be different for your board. Again, on this one, we're just taking some of the edge off here so we have something that we can work with that's square. Okay, I have my push stick and go. Okay, and you can see it didn't quite hit the top edge of this board, so when I lay out my board, this is going to be the edge that I waste. Okay, now we're on to step four. We need to go to the planer and plane this top surface. It might be helpful at this point so that I don't forget. I've already finished this. I'm gonna mark SQ for square. Okay, those two sides are now square, so when I plane it, I'll plane this face. Okay, now we're at the planer for step four of our cutting and squaring stock. I need to set up my planer right now. So I've got it set so the board just touches this green bar. I'm going to go down 8 turns. 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight. And we're gonna run this through. Okay, one pass took all of the board off. Now here's something you can do. If you're not sure if it's cutting the whole thing, is you take your pencil and you put some stripes across it. And if you see any pencil marks on the other side, you need to make one more pass. Okay, now for this one, we're just squaring. We're gonna do our thicknesses in just a minute with a different process. Okay, so we just want this board to be square. I'm gonna go ahead and do a half a turn and make one more pass. Okay, now at this point in the process, if I were just making a single board, I would have dimensioned this down. I would keep running this through the planer until it's the thickness I want. Okay, I also, on the table saw, would have chosen an exact dimension. Right now, we're just making a block of wood to work from. We're going to keep processing this down. And also, since I know I'm going to keep processing this down, I'm not going to cut the ends off. The last two steps would be over here. Our last two steps would be at the miter saw, trim one edge, and then measure the length and cut the last edge. But I'm going to go ahead and leave this long for now. We'll trim our final pieces. That's the very last section. So now we're going to go back to the workbench. We've got some thinking to do now. Okay, I'm back at my worksheet, and I'm looking at this cut list here, and I have these different pieces to make. 1 1/4 by 1 1/4, and this is wrong. We're not going to make 9 of those. We're going to make 2 of those. So we need to make 1 1/4 by 1 1/4 by 4 inches long. Okay, so we're going to stack those end to end on the board. We need 2 inches by a half an inch. We're going to need 5 of those, or 5 inches of those. We need 5 pieces that are 3/4 of an inch by 3/4 of an inch by 2, a 3/4 by 1 by 5 5/16, and a 3/4 by 1 by 2 7/8. How are we going to get that? Okay, what we want to do is we want to look at the board from the end. Okay, think of the board looking this way. We're going to make an expanded drawing of that on our graph paper. Okay, and on my graph paper, I'm going to make 1 square equal 1/4 of an inch. Okay, and my board right now is 3 1/4 by about 1 1/4. It's a little bigger than that, but we want to be conservative here. All right, so that's 1/4, 1/2, 3/4, 1, 1 1/4, 1 1/2, 1 3/4, 2. 2 1/4, 2 1/2, 2 3/4, 3, 3 1/4. That represents the width of my board, and the thickness of my board will be 1/4, 1/2, 3/4, 1, 1 1/4. And again, this is one of the biggest challenges in woodworking, is figuring out how to make a big piece of wood into smaller pieces of wood that we can use. Okay, when I look up here, I'm going to choose the biggest piece first. It looks like that 2 inch by 1/2 inch. Okay, so I'm going to go 1/2 inch down, and we're going to go 2 inches wide. So that's 1/4, 1/2, 3/4, 1, 1 1/4, 1 1/2, 1 3/4, 2. All right, that's this piece right here. Okay, it looks like the next biggest one is the 1 1/4 by 1 1/4. So I'll work from this corner here. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's going to be right in there. That's going to be a close one. I might have taken too much off of my board. Okay, there's 1 1/4 by 1 1/4. Okay, now I need a couple pieces that are 3/4 by 3/4. Okay, so I can go 3/4 is left here, and 3/4 there, and 3/4 by 1. That's going to be this last piece. And it's actually, when I figure my kerf, is going to fit about like that. Okay, 3/4 on this side, 1 inch on this side. Okay, this last part here, the length, we'll worry about that in a second. Okay, now when I cut this, I have to think about what order I want to cut this in. I only see one mark that goes all the way through the board, and that's this one right here. So we're going to make the cut at 2 inches first. Okay, I have a feeling I'm going to regret making these extra cuts on this board because I think this is going to be less than 1 1/4 when we're done. But it's a learning experience, and that's why we're doing this. Okay, we're going to go to the table saw now, and we're going to make these cuts. And I'm going to take my paper with me. I'm going to put my name on it, too, because there's a good chance I'm going to leave it behind. All right, let's go to the table saw now and make these cuts. Okay, the first cut I want to make is this 2-inch wide cut, and then I'm going to turn that board and make it a half of an inch. So I set my fence to 2 inches. Check my blade one more time, and we're going to make this cut. Okay, I'll set this piece aside. Okay, so this is 2 inches wide. Now I need to make a half an inch this way. We're going to make this dimension here. I set my fence to a half an inch. And I need to adjust my blade for my thicker piece of wood. Right there. Okay, the teeth are up above the wood. And one more time. We're going to cut this. Be careful when you go through that your push stick doesn't hit the blade, also your fingers. Okay, so this piece right here is my 2-inch by a half an inch piece. The only thing left to do now is cut that to length. Okay, I've got this piece here, which is supposed to be 3/4 of an inch thick. It clearly is not, but if it were, what I would do next is take my fence, set it to 3/4, and make the cut. That is almost exactly 3/4 of an inch. Okay, so we're gonna use that. Okay, now I've marked that this was square on both sides. The next cut we need to make, we've got 3/4 of an inch thick. That's this board right here. Now I need to go 3/4 of an inch wide, and my next one will be 1 inch wide. My fence is already at 3/4 of an inch, so I can make this cut. Okay, this piece of wood is 3/4 by 3/4. That's this one right here in my drawing. Now I need to make this piece, which is 1 inch by 3/4. We already know it's 3/4 this way, so we're going to set our fence to 1 inch and make this cut. All right, see that little piece of wood right there? Those go down there. We're going to wait till the saw comes to a complete stop. We're going to reach in and grab that. Okay, so now I have 3 of my 4 boards cut. I have my 2-inch piece here, my 3/4 by 3/4 here, my 3/4 by 1 here, and I'm left with a 1 1/4 by 1 1/4. Right. So my last setting on my table saw is 1 1/4. We're gonna take this last piece. This is the edge I wanna get rid of. So I'll probably wanna save this edge and this edge. And unfortunately, as you can see, I cut that too small. But this is the one we're going to turn in. Okay, so we're going to trim this edge down to 1 1/4. Okay, so this is our last piece. Now you can see that by choosing a piece of wood that was too small and by over-machining in the beginning, I've made this unusable for my project. If I were making a jewelry box out of this, I would have to start over and find a new piece to replace this. If we were making high-end woodworking, we would want every piece, every component of the box to come out of the same piece of wood, so you've got the same grain and the same color. Okay, now we're going to go back to the workbench and we're going to plan out the lengths that we need to do. Okay, I'm going to go in order on my cut list here. So I've got my 1 1/4 by 1 1/4 piece, that's this one. and I need two pieces that are 4 inches long. Okay, now I know I'm not gonna trust this. I also know I wanna try to work around this and see if I can sneak 4 inches in. And look at that. I'm gonna readjust here. Okay, I want to try to get 4 inches out of this piece that doesn't have the that flaw in it. And if I look, I just have 4 inches right there, and I've got another 4 inches over here. I'm going to try to move it as close to this as possible to eliminate as much of that. Okay, and again, I'm using pen this time just so you can see the marks that I'm making. So I'm going to make a mark at this end, and I'm going to measure over 4 inches from my mark. It's on the 3, but it's 1, 2, 3, 4 inches, and make another mark. Okay, if I'm making multiple marks, if I put another mark at 4 inches after this, this would actually be too short, because when I cut it, the saw blade is going to make some of that material disappear. So the second piece would be about 1/8 of an inch too short. Okay, so here's one of my two pieces. There's another mark at square, 1, 2, 3, 4 inches. Okay, so this one's set up. The next piece is the 2 inch by 1/2 by 5 inches, and I need two pieces of that. So I'm gonna repeat the same thing I did. And since I'm only making two pieces, I can just mark it from each end. These are gonna be by 5 inches long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And mark square. Make sure when you're marking square that your tri-square is up flush against the edge of the board. And we'll do the same thing from this edge. We'll measure 5 inches. Double check. Yep, that's 5. Okay, now I need 5 from the 3/4 by 3/4 stock. I need 5 pieces that are 2 inches long. We're gonna do a different method on this one. Since I have 5 pieces, I can't make all my marks at once. We're gonna use a different tool on that. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're just going to put a square mark, and I'm going to mark the first piece at 2 inches, and we're going to make repeat cuts on this, and I'll show you how to do that. Okay, and we just need 5 of these. That just means 5 of those. Okay, the last piece of wood is my 3/4 by 1 inch stock. We'll make an end mark here, and the first one is 5 5/16 of an inch long. So we'll just go to the nearest inch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 inches, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5/16. And my second piece is gonna be 2 7/8 inches long. And again, I don't wanna rely on this mark because some amount of that's going to be taken off by the saw blade. So we'll just make a mark on the end. Hopefully I left myself enough room. 1, 2, 7/8. Okay, I'm at the miter saw and I have my pieces ready to cut. All my lines are on here. All I need to do is make my cuts. This part goes pretty quickly. We're going to save this multiple piece for last, and I'll show you a different way to do that. So I'm just going to go to the miter saw, line up my blade so that the blade is outside the line. Okay, now to make these repeated cuts, we're gonna make this a little bit quicker on ourselves. Okay, I'm gonna set my saw for the first cut. Right there. And then we're gonna get a block of wood We're going to clamp it to the fence right here. All right, I have my block of wood. Set it right there. And we always want to double check it. Yep, it moved just a little bit. There we go. Okay, now that wood is barely touching the fence back there. So I'm going to cut really slow so it doesn't fling out and damage the wood. There's one. We're going to try to do that next one without nicking it. Two. Three, that one's on the floor. Four, and I'm not going to be able to cut that one safely. What are you going to do here? Come on, you guys, you know the answer to this. Okay, we're going to have to go to a different tool. I cannot safely make this cut on this saw. Okay, we're going to go over to the crosscut sled to make our last cut. Right here, we have the table saw with the crosscut sled. And I can do basically the same operation, only instead of clamping a block on, I'm going to use the stop block here. This slides into this rail here, like so. And I have my feather board here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this so that it is the same length. And ideally, I would actually have a mark on my board that I would follow. Now, by doing this, there's no chance of kickback because there's nowhere for it to go, and I don't have to have my fingers in here. So I'm going to take my piece of wood. I've got this feather board right here, and if I set this very carefully, I can use the feather board to hold that piece down. I'm making sure that my feather board's not in the path of the blade. Okay, now we can make that last cut. We could have done all five on this tool as well. As you can see, that's a lot smoother. Okay. Move everything out of the way. There's my four boards. The fifth one's on the ground back there.
I've cut all my pieces, and I gathered them all up, and I've got this pile of wood right here. I know some of these are scraps, so before I finish this, I'm actually going to take a minute and sort this all out. I'm going to go in order of my list. So my first piece is 1¼ by 1¼ by 4 inches. I'm going to guess that it's these two. And that is 4 inches long. And it is 1¼ by, that's 1¾. So this one's going to be a little bit off. We're going to go ahead and finish this one anyway. If I were actually making something, I would want to recut those pieces. This is a practice activity. So if it's 1/16 of an inch off, it looks like I'm going to lose 2 points on those two pieces. Okay, now I need the 2 inch by 1/2 inch by 5 inches. I think it's those pieces. So we're going to check 2 by 1/2 by 5. There's 5 by 2 by 1/2. That's my next set of pieces. And I need 3/4 by 3/4 by 2, and I need 5 of those pieces. Looks like those, and I think one of those is going to be scrap. I bet it's that one right there. Okay, so we've got 2 inches, that one's a little bit long, by 3/4 by 3/4. Okay, and if I line these up, those are the same piece. Now, if you really want to know what your score is going to be, measure each and every one of those. Okay, so that's the third item. The fourth item is 3/4 by 1 by 5 5/16. Looks like this one. So there's, let's do this edge. 5 5/16, it's a tad bit long by 3/4 by 1. Okay, there's my fourth checkbox. And the last one is 3/4 by 1 by 2 7/8. So we go 3/4 by 1 by 2 7/8. That one's a tad bit short. Okay, which means these pieces are gonna be scrap. Now, I always tend to hold on to these until I'm completely done, because you never know when you might realize you needed something else, or maybe one of these was a required piece after all. Okay, so what you're gonna turn in to me now are these 11 pieces. Make sure we have 11, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 pieces. You're gonna put your name and period on each one, keep them together in a group. And then when I'm ready to grade these, what I'm gonna do, what I wanna see on your workbench, is this page sitting right here, this group of blocks, put in order of your checkboxes. I'll measure them right on the spot. If we turn these into the basket, we're gonna make a big old mess. So again, take this paper, make sure the top part's filled out, put a check mark by each one that you finish, and you should know your score before I do. Okay, there it is. That's how to do the cutting and squaring stock activity.